Fortnite is gaining so much momentum it is beginning to seriously compete with PUBG, and why would it not? It is free to play, has low system requirements, and it's endless fun. But maybe you need some extra performance in this game no matter what, and you saw my last video on the topic, only to realize that Epic blocked all changes to the configuration file. Seriously, Fortnite, you were doing so well! In any case, a recent update unlocked one thing for us to tweak, and that is better than nothing, so let's talk about that. This is, after all, the LowSpecGamer, a channel where I explore what tweaks are possible in the game to get it somewhat working under the manual requirements. Let's start with the big thing, the internal resolution scaler. Before the recent update, the internal resolution in the menu could only be assigned to some presets and was locked to a lowest value around 44. This has been substituted by a granular slider that goes down to 33.3. And if you navigate to the configuration file in your local app data, don't forget to enable hidden folders in Windows, then you can go to Saved, Config, Windows Client, Game User Settings.ini, and you can find a line that controls the internal resolution as SG.resolution quality. You can assign this to pretty much any value. I will get back to this in a second. Another small thing you can do is add the line Full Screen Mode equals 0 to run the game in exclusive full screen Windows mode, which can, as PC Gaming Wiki calls it, massively boost FPS. Just be sure to test this beforehand, because on certain devices, exclusive full screen can either cause crashes or distort the image in some weird ways. What you're seeing right now is the screen of the GPD Win 2 handheld PC that I talked about in the video in the corner. Let's forget about exclusive full screen for the moment and just manually drop the internal resolution to 60%, with an external resolution of 720p. As I have documented before, the game does really fine, with frame rates of above 40fps. I absolutely love the idea of handheld portable Fortnite, even if it means having to aim with a controller, but that is nothing compared to the discomfort that comes now. You see, on its minimum requirements, Fortnite has very humble GPU requirements, an IntelHD 4000. Lucky for me, patron CoolGamma66 recently donated this CPU for the channel. This is a Sandy Bridge i5 quad-core with a rather high clock rate, which I'm going to combine with this stick of RAM donated by fan Joshua Molchek. I don't think I pronounced it right. So I'm sure I won't be running into memory issues or a CPU bottleneck, but the integrated GPU in this thing is an IntelHD 3000. Haha! Now that is a heck of a GPU bottleneck. To find out if something like this had any possibility, I left the external resolution to 1080 but dropped internal resolution all the way to 15. I think it is obvious this is going to have a strong visual effect, to say at least. Surprisingly, when dropping from the plane or just doing a variety of actions, the game manages to keep it together. I saw frame rates between 20 and 40 at different times, and it is almost surprisingly usable. But when it drops really hard and you really notice it. So, can you play Fortnite on an IntelHD by playing around with the exclusive fullscreen and the internal resolution scaler? Yes. Can you play it on something as low as an IntelHD 3000? Well, that depends on your opinion. The game is free to play, so why not try? If you know any performance tweaks that are not plugged in this game, send me an email or a tweet. I read everything. And thank you to everyone in Patreon who donates money or components or just contributes to my channel in any way. You are all great.